Are you wondering how you can use your math and literacy centers right inside Microsoft Teams? If Microsoft Teams is the platform that your school has chosen to use for distance learning, in this video, I'm going to show you how you can assign digital learning centers, whether they're math or literacy, directly to your students inside Microsoft Teams, and your students never have to leave the platform. Stay tuned. What's up, educational rock stars? Welcome back to my channel. I'm Farah from Farah Henley Education, where I strive to bring you actionable tips and strategies to take right back into your classroom to make your teacher life a little easier. And today's video is no exception. Now, if this is your first time joining us, be sure you hit like and subscribe and so that you get notified when we go live or upload a new video here on the channel. Now, if your school has decided to use Microsoft Teams for your distance learning and connecting with your students, you may be wondering how in the world are you going to assign digital math and literacy centers in your classroom? Maybe you've purchased My K-4 digital literacy and math bundles, or maybe you are part of the Learning Centers Made Easy membership, or maybe you've got learning centers from another platform, but you are wondering, how am I going to use those inside Microsoft Teams, especially since Microsoft Teams does not play nice with Google from what I have been able to see. Now, in today's tutorial, I'm going to be showing you how you can use the digital learning centers that I have from Seesaw inside Microsoft Teams, and your students never have to leave the app. So let's dive in to today's tutorial. Hey there, rock stars. So I want to do a really, really quick tutorial on how you can use your digital centers inside Microsoft Teams. Now, I will tell you that I don't have a Microsoft for Education account because you have to be with a school in order to do that. So, but this trick will work even if I'm going to be showing you it on my personal Teams account, but this will work if you have an education account as well. So, you aren't going to be able to use your Google Docs. In fact, I have spent hours upon hours trying to figure out how to do Google Docs with Microsoft Teams, and that is not something that seems to be available. So the tips that I have given some of the teachers that have purchased either my digital center bundles or are members in the Learning Centers Made Easy membership, I've told them that they could set up Google Drives for all of their students. They could make copies of the Google Drives or the Google Slides centers for each of their students and put it in each of their folders and then send each of their students their individual links, which is a lot of work. But I've also included the digital centers preloaded into Seesaw. And so I want to show you how you can actually use Seesaw. Now, Seesaw is completely free to teachers. And I know a lot of teachers say, well, I don't want to have to use another learning management system in order to do all of this with my students. But here's the deal. You can still use Microsoft Teams and assign your Seesaw assignments inside a Microsoft Teams, and by using this quick little trick that I learned, and your students never have to leave Microsoft Teams. Now, you as the teacher would still have to go over to Seesaw. You need to enter your students' names and get their logins and things like that, but your students themselves would never actually have to leave the Teams app. So let me show you how to do that. So what you're going to do is you're going to go up to, now if I go over to this team right here and I go to general, you're going to see that I have these two. I have Seesaw up here and I have Boom. So you can do this with Seesaw and with Boom Learning. And I want to show you how I did that. So if I go up here to this one, you'll see that they're not up there. The way that I'm going to do that is I'm going to hit that little plus button and I'm going to come down here and I'm going to search for website, which it's right up here at the beginning because of recent. So I'm going to hit website. I'm going to give the tab a name, Seesaw, and then I'm going to just put the URL here. So it is web.seesaw.me, and you do need the beginning of that. I've tried to do it without it before and it just doesn't work. It says this isn't a valid URL. Oh, sorry. There it goes. I needed the S. So anyway, so then I'm going to hit save. And you'll notice that it's added Seesaw up here. Now watch what happens. It opens that Seesaw. Now here's what I suggest for Seesaw. I suggest that you go over to the Seesaw website in a browser and that you go ahead and hit that login button. Now it's probably going to log me in automatically, so I'm going to go ahead and come over here and log out. Because here is the page that you want. So you'll notice it's a different login or a different page. So go ahead and copy and paste that. I will leave that link actually down below so that you can do that. So now I'm going to come over here and I'm going to hit, let's see, about this tab. I think, is there a way for me to edit this tab? Settings, yes. And I'm going to change that to the login page and hit save. Now what I have discovered is, see, it automatically logged me in as a student because I have this on another tab as well. But now I'm logged in as a student, and once your students are logged in, the same thing would happen when they hit the Seesaw tab. It's going to take them to their Seesaw, their student account for Seesaw, and they can do everything right here. They can actually even do the activities right here. You'll see they have all their tools and everything right inside Microsoft Teams. So if you are using Digital Centers, you won't be using the Google Slides Digital Centers. You'll be using the Seesaw Digital Centers. You will still need to go set them up with a Seesaw account so that they have a login. But again, they are never going to go to the Seesaw website. They will do everything right here inside Teams. Only you as the teacher will have to go to the Seesaw site. The same thing is going to happen for Boom. So if I wanted to add Boom up here, I would simply go and type in HTTPS. My husband is cooking breakfast. I apologize for the sizzling bacon in the background. And then wow.boomlearning.com and hit okay, save, and it's going to add the Boom Learning tab right there, and it's going to bring this page, and then you can see I'm signed in as my business account, but if I was a student, I could sign as a student, and I would be able to play everything right here in Boom, and I'll show you how that works. I'm just going to bring this one up right here, and everything works right here inside Microsoft Teams, and my students never had to leave the Microsoft Teams site. So I hope this quick tutorial, it's super simple, super easy, and I do understand now once you get ready to assign assignments, I'm not totally familiar with Microsoft Teams. I just know that that is a way for you to add Seesaw and use your digital centers, your math and literacy centers inside Microsoft Teams, as well as your digital Boom cards right inside Microsoft Teams without having to use the FastPen, because the beauty of Boom is that you can get all of that data, and now you can still have that. So you as a teacher would still have to go to Seesaw and to Boom and enter your students and give them accounts and get their logins and so forth, and then you would need to have to figure out how you're going to get those logins to students. And what I have found is once your students log in on their device to Microsoft Teams and to these websites, it keeps you logged in, but I suggest you keep some sort of login card or whatever, like you would do with your students in your classroom, and have those logins for the students. Again, the students are never having to actually leave Microsoft Teams to go to these websites. Everything's done right inside the Microsoft Teams app. So, and assigning assignments, like I said, I don't have the assignments tab up here. You would need to figure out how you're going to let your students know, hey, you need to go into Seesaw, click the link up at the above, you need to, or up at the top, you need to go into Boom and complete this assignment. How you would assign those is completely up to you within the Microsoft Teams platform. I hope this tutorial has helped you see how you can still use your math and literacy digital centers right inside Microsoft Teams, and you can help your students get the differentiated practice, review, and enrichment that they need. Now, if you are looking for more tips and strategies to take back into your classroom, be sure and check out the videos on your screen. Thanks for watching, and keep being an educational rock star.